بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So we've completed the Kitab Allah. So before we go on to Sunnah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are going to just clarify some issues. I'm not clarify, we're just going to summarize everything. So first of all, what do we have? We went through المقدمة, that's the root of the أصول الفقه, تعريف موضوع غاية. Then we went through تقسيم الأول. We said what? تقسيم الأول is how the word has been coined. It's coined for one word, one meaning, is either خاص or عام. If there's many أفراد, it's going to be عام. One fard is going to be خاص. If has multiple meanings, it's going to be one meaning is fixed, it becomes مؤول. If the عام becomes, you take out some members, it becomes what عام مخصوص. If it doesn't have, you don't take out any members, it becomes what غير مخصوص. If it means عام غير مخصوص. خاص is قطعي الدلالة. عام is also قطعي الدلالة. When it becomes مخصوص, what happens now? It becomes ظني الدلالة. Okay? مؤول is ظني. Yes? Okay? Then under khas, we are on afterwards, we are on after the whole taqseem, we are on to different types of am. We have amr, we have nahi, we have mutlaq, we have muqayyad. What's amr? قول قائل لغيري افعل على وجه الاستئلاء. Then nahi is prohibition. Mutlaq is when you have an unrestricted khas. And muqayyad is basically when you do what? You put an adjective or a mudaf ilay onto a particular type. Al-raqaba mu'min, etc. Then after that, we are on to qism al-thani, is how the word is used. It's used haqiqatan for the ma wudhi'a lahu. مجازاً غير ما وضع له. صريح is that word is used in that meaning explicitly, and that word is used in that meaning كناية when it's not used explicitly in that meaning. Are you following? Understood? جي. You got it? Then after it went through what? حقيقة. We said حقيقة. We have حقيقة أولى من المجاز was one movie then. The حقيقة is always preferential over the مجاز. Make sure the lights are clear. Okay, then we have here حقيقة متعذرة محجورة مستعملة. We went through those categorizations. Then we said حقيقة خلف الحقيقة في المجاز خلف الحقيقة في اللفظ أو في الحكم. Imam Abu Hanifa and Sahih in the bridge, the two categorizations we had to go through. Then you can't have both حقيقة and مجاز meaning all at once. Then we discussed the علاقة, the علاقة, the what do you call it, the سبب, سبب إلا سبب مناسبة. You call it مناسبة. And then why do you need the حقيقة meaning عرف نفس الكلام سياق الكلام متكلم أو محل الكلام. We discussed those things regarding حقيقة المجاز. Then after that we went through ظاهر نص مفسر المحكم. And opposite to that you have what خفي مشكل مجمل متشابه. And we went through قسم التقسيم الرابع. How do you do the استدلال؟ عبارة النص إشارة النص دلالة النص اقتضاء النص. And after that we said the first three have وجوه البيان. You can have تقرير تفسير تغيير ضرورا تبديل. فهمتم؟ انتهينا من بحث كتاب الله مختصرا. تقبل الله منا. سبحان الله وبحمده. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت ونستغفرك ونتوب إليك.